Hey, Casey. What's the forest's favorite shape?
Please, Anderson. Just one case without the rent.
A triangle.
I don't get it.
Yes, you do.
Is nagging at me. Need to look at the case board.
A locked box.
Is that the cult of the tree symbol on it? Notes and ammo. Looks like they're tools of the trade.
Saga edged toward the broken door, her gun ready, flashlight aimed ahead. Nightingale said it would be here. The Cauldron Lake General Store was overgrown, left to rot. Saga thought about the cult of the tree. They had been here, waiting, planning a gruesome ritual murder. Meanwhile, they played cards in the general store, like it was just another late-night poker game. Saga stepped closer to the door. Had the animal broken it? There was a loud crash. Saga found herself face to face with a cultist, a hulking figure in a raincoat. We watch in the night, wild eyes behind a plastic deer mask, an axe in his raised hand. The rider went into the lake, banished the dark presence. Taken still lurked in the woods. The dark place receded. The current pulled back those with darkness inside, into the lake. Nightingale was there, one of them. The dark presence, Jagger had taken him. The witch had stolen his heart. They sank beneath the waves.
There's something written here. A poem? Or a riddle? Reminds me of the nursery rhymes I read to Logan when she was little. A little clothespin doll. Perfect weird souvenir for Logan. Something feels different. I should look around. A charm. Cute. It'll go great on the bracelet Logan made for me. Huh. That was strange. Gotta keep an eye out for more of these rhymes. The cult is leaving supplies around for themselves. Another one of those rhymes.
Children in Bright Falls all grew up hearing stories about the cult of the tree. Feral maniacs living in the woods. Satanists chanting, "We watch in the night," as they perform blood sacrifices in the forests. Or things not quite human lurking in the dark. There were many versions of the story, but they all shared one important element. Danger in the dark, in the woods. Somewhere among all the urban legends lay a secret truth. The real identity of the cultists prowling in the woods. Real faces hid behind the masks. Real hands held the knives. Real people fulfilling a grim purpose. The forest was not safe. People were right to keep their children away from the trees.
Creepy dolls, mysterious rhymes. No weirder than anything else going on, I guess. Keep trying. Okay. There's a rhyme over here. Rest easy, buddy. Nightingale goes missing for 13 years, shows up murdered, and then turns into a monster. After I stop Nightingale, a rider who's also been missing for 13 years turns up. What's the connection? What kind of case is this? Think, Saga. I have a weird feeling something's changed. What is this? Oh, shit. Another charm for my bracelet.
We've reached the car, Anderson. How's it going down there?
I think I'm done here. I'll meet you at the parking lot. Warning. Activity detected. AWE. Event in progress. Cauldron Lake. What's an AWE? Casey, what exactly does the FBC do?
After New York, when I started looking for our friend here, their name came up. I pushed them for any files they had on him, but got stonewalled. They have a reputation of showing up for weird shit. They have a presence here, and now we find our writer. How about that?
Ready to go?
Mr. Wake, we're taking you back to our field office in Bright Falls. You can freshen up there, and then we'll talk properly.
Mom, before you say anything, I'm totally fine. Don't freak out. Dad shouldn't have even texted you.
Logan? No one texted me. What's going on?
I'm totally fine. I slipped, that's all. God, it's not the end of the world.
Put your father on the phone.
Okay. Dad, it's Mom.
Don't worry, hon. Logan slipped in the shower and bumped her head. She has a slight concussion, but I'm keeping an eye on her. Lucky I heard her fall. She could have drowned.
Jesus, David. Why didn't you call?
I tried. It didn't go through. She's fine, really. But what about you? You sound stressed.
No, it's, just a weird case, that's all.
Well, if you need a hint, my years of board game victories tell me Colonel Mustard did it.
I'll keep an eye out for him. Love you, Dave.
Love you too, honey. Want to say bye to Logan?
Just tell her I love her. Bye for now. Is there anyone you'd like us to reach out to, Mr. Wake? You've been gone a long time.
No. No. They'd be in danger. It'll come for me.
Okay, let's talk about something else. Robert Nightingale. Do you know him? You were both here in 2010.
The Dark Presence got him back then. That's the last time I saw him. 13 years.
Tell us about the pages. You had what looks like a title page with you. Return. Is this the name of the story on these pages? The writer's name has been scratched out pretty violently, but your name can still be made out underneath.
Scratched out. Yeah. Scratch.
Did you write these pages, Mr. Wake?
I'm trying to remember. It's a crazy jumble, like a nightmare. It doesn't make sense. But I remember.
Waking up in places with no memory of how I'd gotten there. It was out of control. I didn't need another mugshot in the fucking tabloids. Had I already done the show? Was that a recording?
Good to see you, Alan. This must be an exciting time for you. Tell me, does it ever get old?
Sorry, does what get old?
Publishing a new book. Are you okay there, my friend? You look like you've been cooped up in the writer's room for a few too many years.
This is exactly how I feel.
You know, I've waited so long to get my hands on the sequel to Departure. You left us on quite the cliffhanger. We've all been dying to know what "it's not a lake, it's an ocean" really means.
You and me both.
Well, our wait is over. Your new book, Initiation, hits the shelves tomorrow.
What?
That's exactly what every reader will be asking. This book is mind-bending. It's so cerebral. I mean, how would you describe it? An auto-fictional thought experiment? A horror story? A postmodern detective story?
Wait. This isn't right. I haven't written anything.
He's so humble.
Okay, you got me. Good prank, very funny. But yeah, sad to say, I've not written this. I'd remember if I'd written a book, right?
Or maybe it was written by your evil double. Well played, man! That is spot on! Playing the role here! Pretending the world of the book overlaps our own? That's very meta indeed. You see, Initiation tells the story of a fictional writer named Alan Wake, who is trapped in a nightmare, desperately trying to find the manuscript of a novel he has forgotten he has written. The book is set in New York, but it might not be New York at all. He is tormented by his dark doppelganger and guided by visions of a fictional detective he has written. That's right. Alex Casey is in this book as well.
I guess we'll just keep doing this the whole show. The joke's on me.
But isn't that what you sign up for with autofiction? No, but seriously, I found the structure of the reality you build in the book fascinating. It reminded me of The Matrix. I mean, the writer is physically in his writer's room, trapped there, and he projects himself out to this dark dream of New York through the story he is writing. Like astral projection. Did I get that right?
Yeah, that's exactly right. Go on. I should be taking notes here. This is great stuff.
Notes to that other Alan Wake in that room writing this as we speak? Are we all in your story, Alan? Wow. I wish you every success with your new book, Alan. I hope it's as successful as your best-selling Alex Casey series. Initiation hits the shelves tomorrow. After this, I'm sure we'll all be eagerly awaiting the culmination of this hero's journey trilogy of yours. A book called Return, perhaps.
Man,
thank you for one of the strangest interviews of my entire career, Alan. All this talk of meta narratives. I'm expecting to disappear once this scene ends.
Hello? I'm losing it. Something's not right here. I needed to get home. To Alice. What the hell was that interview? Some kind of joke? Initiation? I never wrote a book called Initiation.
This felt like a bad dream. Could make a good horror story. Old Gods of Asgard. That name sounded familiar.
Hey! I think I've been locked in! Anybody?
Fuck. Now I have to find the code myself. Great.
Transmission I couldn't quite make out. What was that? A message? Impossible to say.
Gasping for air. This place felt familiar. A ghost of a memory surfaced about riding here for countless days. A plot board for mapping out a story. On the index cards, the nightmare that just happened to me. A summary of the story so far. But other notes as well. Warnings. I had written them. I couldn't remember what it all meant. The name Scratch filled me with dread. I could trust these words.
I had to act on them. You must write to escape.
In the film series. And of course, we have Alan Wake here, the best-selling writer of the books the films are based on. Let's do this!
Welcome back to the show. So, Alan, as the creator of the character, how do you feel about this?
Sorry, what?
I know it can be an awkward question with the man sitting right next to you, but I mean, how do you feel about him in the role of Casey? Does he look the part to you?
He looks exactly like I always imagined Casey to be. It's uncanny.
Thank you. That means so much to me. I'm a huge fan of your books.
So, what's the problem, Alan? Because on more than one occasion, you voiced your reservations about the adaptations.
It's not that. They're their own thing. They've gone with choices that are different from mine. I feel protective about my stories, and these adaptations... I don't know. I guess I just wish I could have been more involved in making them.
Well, in that case, you won't have seen this either. We have a clip from the new film, Murder Case Casey. Should we roll it, or do you want to say something first, Sam?
Nah, just roll it.
This city was an old scar that refused to heal. The rain made it fester. It needed the sun, but there was only the night. I was tired. Insomnia covered me like a plastic film. I was watching the world through a rain-slick window, my own reflection haunting the view. I was trying to track down a missing writer. My only clue was a table lamp, shaped like an angel, the only thing to shed light on this sordid mystery.
Great. Murder Case Casey. Great job, Sam. Very exciting and very meta. I'm looking forward to seeing more.
Wait, stop. What was that about a writer? About a lamp? Hello?
Lorraine, there you are, Tom. Oh, not so much evil, that not a bit of good as well. Not one without the other. Good to see you.
Hey, I can't seem to find my way out of here. Can you point me to the exit?
Not the hell of it is. Of course, Tom. The work will instruct its maker. I was gonna get something from the basement for you, but you can get it yourself now. The more cooks, the worse the soup.
What do you want me to get from the basement? And my name's Alan, not Tom.
Yeah, but I got up ago. A man, but a man with a tool makes two, Tom. And a man with a tool can build his own exit. It's in a shoebox, in the basement where you left it. Safe as in the Lord's purse. Here's the key.
I've been trying to find a way to escape the dark place. Any suggestions?
He who mulls about his troubles is the prisoner of his troubles. It's not easy to get out. But don't you worry, Tom. The home is still there where the heart is. I often think about it when I mop the floor and look into the puddle. Water is the memory of the world. Water finds its way.
Have we met before? Are you trapped in the dark place, too?
You remember Ahti, the janitor. You can't be lost if you don't worry about where you are headed. So don't worry, Tom. The sun will shine even into a heap of twigs. Just remember to turn on the lights. It won't take long when you get to work.
The janitor was a bit out there, but still a friendly face. I had to trust the basement would get me out of here.
Don't
An old lamp and a shoebox. Was this what the janitor had left for me? The lamp felt significant. A tool for bringing light to the darkness. I felt a magnetic pull between the lamp and the light overhead. Whoa! When the light jumped into my lamp, the whole room changed. Like something in a dream. Opening a way forward, the lamp was humming. The bulb glowed. It held the light now. I felt another surge from the lamp. I could use it again. The glow in the lamp went out, shifting the light in the room. The light carved out something new from the darkness.
Wants to drown me. I'm losing myself. I have to fight it. I have to remember. The clicker. The light switch. I lost it. But I have the lamp now. The lamp the switch was cut from. This place is a nightmare. Not real, and yet more real than anything. The danger and the horror are real. It feeds off my mind. Twisting whatever it takes into psychotic reality. I'm trapped here. I write to escape. I've tried this many times, written countless stories, forgotten how many. I keep failing, but I must keep trying. I use the story to dive deeper. Every word I write is a step forward on this spiral in the darkness. I dive to the body to find the answer, the map, the key, the compass. It's combined to form a door leading out. But how do you open a door that's not a door?
bottom of an ocean. That's not an ocean. And a lake. That's not a lake.
The phone was ringing. Somehow I knew the call was for me.
Hello?
Alan Wake?
Yes.
Do you know who I am?
No. Who is this?
We'll get to that later. There are spies all over. Shadows.
A sense of deja vu washed over me. Had I had this conversation before?
Alan, listen to me carefully. Caldera Street Station, the subway. You need to go there. I'll call you again later. Make sure to pick up.
Do I know you? I know you from somewhere.
You've just forgotten again. We're in this together. Don't worry. I got you now. We've been working great.
I'm losing you. Hello? Hello?
The man had said Caldera Street Station. I had to go there.
nightmare dimension, an ocean of darkness. Remember, its dark energy can make art come true, make dreams and nightmares come true. Yes, I can use this. I need to use this. Hungry, monstrous things. They're trying to stop me. They devour me. Become me.
Caldera Street station sign was there, but the entrance was missing. I had to make it appear. Maybe I could use the lamp to reveal the station entrance. The lamp was dead in my hand. I needed to find a light for it. There was a light at the end of the alley ahead.
Is this the way it was in the page?
What the hell? Oh, hey. We met at Dor's show.
Alan Wake, the writer. I'm Alex Casey. Looking into a murder.
Come on, what is this?
There's a piece of evidence, a manuscript of a novel. You wouldn't know anything about it?
A manuscript? What manuscript? I need to see it.
Rumor had it the manuscript contained the details of the murders. A murder cult was following the story to commit their gruesome acts. Was Wake their leader? Had he written it? How far would he go to create a perfect work of art? Or would he be the next victim? Stay here.
No, wait! I need a gun!
No chance.
Thank you.
dream I had. He was just gonna keep killing me here, loop by loop. You're not gonna get what you want. You think you know. You know shit. You don't really wanna know. You're gonna get what's coming to you.
This was an echo of the books I had written for years. Picking up Casey's gun felt like I was assuming the role of the detective. I had a light now. I needed to get back to the subway station entrance. Shit. With the alley in darkness now, restless shadows block my way. Didn't. They were trying to stop me. With the gun and flashlight, I could fight back. I could use the light to open the subway entrance now. I needed to find a way around that fence. written books about Alex Casey for years. Something lingered here. A line from a half-forgotten story.
Some sins, the evidence of the crimes committed, could never be erased. Not by the rain, or any amount of therapy from Dr. Jack Daniels. It remained bruises under my skin.
There was something hidden here. Light would reveal it.
Alan Wake.
A phrase repeated over and over. The words resonated with meaning. Had I written this?